I met some nice Swedish tourists called Lars, Lars and Lars, and I coaxed it out of them for $10,000.
We can't afford it.
Well, that's right.
Mummy, maybe a trip to the outback could help me get over this little phase I'm going through. And you never know, I might meet some lovely country girl.
I hereby christen this budget Barbie camper Priscilla, Queen of the Desert.
I think it was Ray's idea. You talk, I think I can save your life. Son, six people are dead, and someone has to pay for it. Now it can be you, or it can be Ray. Lewis, he called you queer. Said at casitas you took it up the ass.
I didn't kill nobody!
Son, you know what's gonna happen to you if you don't talk. You'll go to the gas chamber, so for God's sake, admit what you did.
I didn't mean to hurt her. Maybe she's okay.
Okay. Well, these people are all in the morgue. They were dead when you left them.
If I could just reach over and touch her side of the bed, I would know that it was cold. But I can't. I know I can't have her back, but I don't want to wake up in the morning thinking she's still here. I lie here not knowing how long I've been alone. So how can I heal? How am I supposed to heal if I can't feel time?
Well, he buys all his clothes from Bloomingdale's. But because he's from London, everybody on the Cape keeps talking about his fabulous English look, which really is so good. He was at a party up there last weekend, and Norman Mailer walked up and punched him in the stomach, and when Mark asked him why, he just said it was for wearing a pink coat. I know I should have been happy for Mark that Norman Mailer punched him, but all I could think was, will Norman Mailer ever punch me? I don't even have a pink coat. Or get invited to those glamorous kinds of parties.
Andy, why do you come to confession?
Well, because it's a sin. Not to.
Mikey stayed behind in Clarence.
Left Mikey alone.
You met a girl.
Mikey met a girl.
Hi.
Mikey met a girl.
What's her name, Charlie?
Molly.
Molly.
Molly O'Boyle.
Molly O'Boyle.
A red-headed Corleone, no doubt.
Aye. Red.
Like the sunset.
Like the sunset.
Do you mean immortal? You hicks are a sideshow unto yourselves. Sheriff, you any idea what a Thompson submachine gun does to a mortal?
Well, this ain't Chicago. You can't just shoot him. Do that, people around here will string us up from a tree.
Do I look stupid to you?
If you're as smart as I think you are, you'd know to walk right on by me like we've never seen each other before in our lives. And you'd know to feel lucky. You'll come unstuck. I got a feeling about it. I think you do too. I reckon you probably carry that feeling around with you every second of the day.
That's what this is about. Brushing up. Hence the elocution lessons. That's the scoop around town.
I'm trying to...
Yearning for a larger audience, are we, Bertie?
Don't.
What's that? I'm sorry. Younger brother trying to push older brother off the throne. Positively medieval.
I'll tell you what God's given you.
He's put a bullet in you. And he's abandoned you out here to me. He feels nothing for you. He couldn't give a fuck if you died tomorrow. God gave you a brother who's not waiting for you. He gave you a brother who's not even thinking about you right now. Just because you and him come out of the same woman's hole. The only thing that means anything right now is that I'm here. And he's not.
Does she not know that her body is the temple of the Holy Spirit which she received from God? This is a disgrace. She will be punished in hell. She will be transformed into a thorny tree. And in a tortured wood, she will be punished by harpies who will dig their sharp talons into her until the blood comes flowing down.